Ladies and gentlemen, you're about to see a story of murder, greed, corruption, violence, exploitation, adultery, and treachery. All of those things we all hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
Oh, Brad.
Yeah, I'm afraid so, Roxy.
Oh, Brad!
Yeah?
Nobody walks out on me.
Sweetheart!
Don't sweetheart to me, you son of a bitch!
Sometimes I'm down, and sometimes I'm up. do with it,
Officer? Now we're getting to the real story.
And you want to know why? He was trying to walk out on me. The louse.
That's a pretty cold-blooded murder, Mrs. Hart. They're liable to hang you for that one.
Hang me?
Not so tough anymore now, are you?
Amos, did you hear what he said? Oh, son of a bitch.
And now, the six murdering murderesses of the Cook County Jail, in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
Cicero, Lipschitz, pump, six, squish.
Oh,
Cicero, Lipschitz.
Johnny, how could you tell me that I was wrong?
to say we broke up because of our artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
If you want my brain, Roxy Hard Dog.
Lord, dear.
Mr. Billy Flynn, best criminal lawyer in Chicago. Oh, what he don't know about juries and women.
Well, how do you get Billy Flynn?
Not by praying, dearie. First you give me $100 and I make a phone call.
I see. And how much does he get?
$5,000.
$5,000?
Well, he's worth every cent. Ain't never lost a case for a female client yet.
Never?
Never. I'd be glad to make that phone call for you, dearie.
Mr. Flynn. That's what he said. But she's my wife, Mr. Flynn. I'll give you $20 a week out of my salary. I'll give you notes with interest. Double. Triple. Till every cent is paid, Mr. Flynn. I promise you. I promise you.
You know, that's petty. To care for a woman that much is really very touchy. But I have a motto, and that motto is this. Play square. Dance square. Sit down. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask you was she guilty. I didn't ask what she is. I didn't ask you was she a drunk or a dopey. No foolish questions like that, now did I? No. All I said was, have you got $5,000? Did you say yes? You haven't got $5,000. So I figure you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took her case, and I'll keep it. Because I play square. Now look, Bart, I'm not a brat. I don't like to blow my own horn. But believe me, if Jesus Christ had lived in Chicago today, and if he had $5,000 and he'd come to me, things would have turned out differently. Now here's what we're gonna do. By tomorrow morning, I'm gonna have her name on the front page of every newspaper in town. She'll be a celebrity. Hottest little jazz slayer since Bill McKelly. She'll be famous, see? Then we announce we're gonna hold an auction. Tell them we gotta raise money for her defense. They'll buy anything she ever touched. Her shoes, her dresses, her perfume, her underwear. Plus, we tell them, if by due process of law she gets hanged, the stuff triples in value. And that's how we raise the rest of the $5,000. I'll give you 20% of everything we make over that, and that's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
I don't figure you got a choice. You see, either I get the entire $5,000. Or you'll rot in jail before I bring you to trial.
Rotten jail? Well, you don't really mean that, do you?
I certainly do.
Well, look, Mr. Flynn, I've never been very good at this sort of thing. I've always had a great deal of trouble expressing myself. But couldn't we possibly make some sort of arrangement? I can be an awfully good sport.
Hey, you mean one thing to me. $5,000 and that's all. Get it? Now, in a few minutes, we're going to have a big press conference here. There'll be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters, and that sob sister from the Evening Star is coming. I don't figure we'll have any trouble with her. She'll swallow hook, line, and sinker because it's what she wants.
What? sympathy from the press. They're not all pushovers like that Mary Sunshine. Chicago is a tough town.
How tough is it?
It's gotten so tough, they shoot the girls right out from under you. But there's one thing they can never resist, and that's a reformed sinner. So I decided to rewrite the story of your life. Starts tomorrow in the Star, from convent to jail.
Convent? Oh, Mr. Flynn, they'll never believe that.
Oh, no. Get this. Beautiful Sun Home. Every luxury and refinement. Parents dead, educated in the sacred hall. A runaway marriage, fortune swept away. A lovely, innocent girl, bewildered by what's happened. Young, full of life. Lonely, you were caught up by the mad will of a great city. Jazz, cabarets, liquor! Sit down!
You were drawn, like the moth, to the flame. And now that mad will has ceased. A butterfly crushed on the wheel. You have sinned, and you are sorry.
God, that's beautiful!
Cut out, God, too. Stay where you're better acquainted. The important thing to remember when the reporters get here is remorse, regret. You're sorry. Sorry! You would give your life gladly to bring him back. Now, when they ask you why you killed him, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel and he threatened to kill you. You can still see him coming towards you with that awful look in his eyes. And get this, you both reach for the gun. That's your grounds, self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporters are here.
Let him in, Butch. Regret, and you both reach for the gun. Ah, gentlemen, Miss Sunshine. It's always a pleasure to see the members of the press. You know my client, Miss Rusty Hart?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm just so flattered you all came to see me. I guess you wonder why I shot the bastard.
Sit down, dummy!
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rag. Notice how his mouth never moves. Almost.
Where'd you come from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under, but she was granted one more start. The convict of the sacred bar.
Where'd you get here?
1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I'm an anus, and he stole my heart away.
name in the paper. Before Amos, I used to date this well-to-do ugly bootlegger. He used to like to take me out and show me off. Ugly guys like to do that. Once it said in the paper, Gangland's Al Capelli seen at Che Vito with cute red-headed Corrine. That was me. I clipped it out and saved it. Now look. Roxy, rock Chicago. Here, read this. Look, I'm gonna tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. The thing is, see, I'm older than I ever intended to be. All my life, I wanted to be a dancer in vaudeville. Yeah, have my own act. But no, 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 no. They always turned me down. It was one big world full of no. Life. Then Amos came along. Sweet, safe Amos, who never says no. You know, some guys are like mirrors. And when I catch myself in Amos's face, I'm always a kid. Well, you could love a guy like that. Look now, I gotta tell ya, and I hope this ain't too crude. In the bed department, Amos was zero. I mean, when we went to bed, he made love to me like he was six in a carburetor or something. I love you, honey. I love you. Well, to make a long story short, I started fooling around. Then I started screwing around. Just fooling around without dinner. I gave up the vaudeville idea because after all those years, you sort of figure opportunity just passed you by. Ooh, but it ain't. Oh, no, 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 but it ain't. If this Flynn guy gets me off, and with all this publicity, I could still get into vaudeville. I could still have my own act. Now, I got me a world full of yes. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy. The lady breaking in the chips is gonna be Roxy.
Rock.
week raises $200.
I see that tomato's name on the front page. It drives me nerves.
I'm bad. I got some bad news.
What do you mean?
I mean the tour. The whole tour. Down the ground. Canceled. Out. Here.
Canceled?
Well, your name ain't been in the papers for a long time. Been getting calls from William Morris all day. We've lost interest. We've lost interest. We own the water. She's washed up. She's a bum. You know how it hurts, Mama, to hear things like that about someone you cared for.
Sure.
All you read about now is that heart kick. She's hot.
Mama, I've got an idea. Suppose I ask Hart to do that sister act with me.
Now that's why I call you Zelly Yokanoodle.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly in an act of desperation.
Why don't I show you?
something else. Your friend Mama, she told me that she could make some phone calls for me. You know what I told her? I don't need you. And I'm telling you the same thing. I don't need anybody. Haven't you read the papers lately? I'm a star. I'm a big star. Single.
Thanks.
Oh, nothing personal, you understand. Nothing personal.
Nothing personal. Nothing's ever personal.
Yes, that's my question.
Oh, that's a very high spirit.
Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
What the hell do I care about pineapples? Did you get my trial date?
Take it easy, kid. I'll get to it. I'll get to it.
I've got a question about my trial date, too.
Oh, yeah. Hiya, Velma. First things first, honey. I'll get to it. I'll get to it. All right, gentlemen. All right.
Pineapples. I got a feeling you're in trouble, Roxy.
Socialite? You lose again, Velma.
There's only one person who can help you now, Roxy.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Miss Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
Thank you.
sympathy will go to you, not him.
You'll be the poor little deserted mother to me, and that crumb is running out on you.
That's my kid. That's my kid.
Because they can count.
Can you count? Look, here's a copy of Roxy's first statement. It says she hadn't copulated with you for 4 months prior to the, incident.
That's right. We hadn't done no copulating for 4 months. Early fall. Now, wait!
But I want you to forget all that. My client needs your support.
Well, that don't work out right. I couldn't possibly be the father.
Divorce her! Is that what you said?
My God, man, you wouldn't divorce her over a little thing like that. Would you?
You're damn right. That's what I'll do. I'll divorce her. She probably wouldn't even notice.
Are you still here, Andy? I thought you'd gone.
Yeah, I'm still here. I think. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat, fed you fish and scratched your ears.
You'd notice him.
Suppose you was a woman wed and sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You'd notice him. Are human beings made of more than air? With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless that human being next to you is unimpressive, undistinguished, you know who.
I'm there. I tell you.
Where is she anyway?
Oh, she's in there, looking over all her presents. You ought to see them. Legs pouring in from all over. Can you imagine Roxy Hart a mother? That's like making Leopold and Lowe scoutmasters. Listen, Flynn, I've been thinking a lot about my tribe, and I figure if I'm sensational in court, I could get things moving again, you know what I mean? Could I just show you what I thought I'd do on the witness stand?
Yeah, sure, sure, go ahead.
Hit it!
Wise up, kid. They'd love you a lot more if you were hanged. You know why?
Because it would sell more papers.
You're fired!
I quit!
Any lawyer in this town would die to have my case.
You're a phony celebrity, kid. You're a flash in the pan. In a couple of weeks, nobody will even know who you are. That's Chicago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah!
Yeah? You'll just see about that.
No, no!
And I want my 5 grand back, too!
No! No, no!
I'm sorry, Erin, she still says no.
That much I'm hearing, I can understand. Ask her once more.
She says no.
I can understand that too. Jesus Christ, don't she know she's a loser for sure? Look, tell her she's got no case. Tell her she'll be convicted. She'll sit in jail for years. How would she like that?
Huh?
Listen, you better get this accurately. She says Uncle Sam is just and fair, and he would have put her in jail because she's innocent. Erin, I think she's telling the truth.
So what? What the hell has innocence got to do with it? Look, Mrs. Morton, this is a court-appointed thing, understand? I don't get anything from this, you know? Nothing at all!
What do you want from me? I've done my best!
Stop!
Goddamn fool, honky nut! Huh?
She says, will Uncle Sam like her?
I don't give a goddamn what she says unless it's guilty!
Not guilty! Erin?
Yes! He's ready for you.
Well, here you go.
Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty, Uncle Sam!
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure and entertainment, we proudly present the one, the only Catalan cognac and her famous Hungarian road trip.
After 47 years, a Cook County precedent has been shattered. Kathleen Hunyak was hanged tonight for the brutal axe murder of her husband. The Hungarian's last words were, "Not guilty."
Billy? Billy? I hate this dress.
It's what I want you to wear.
I look like a Woolworth's lampshade in it. I don't want to wear it.
You're wearing whatever I tell you to wear.
As a matter of fact, you're doing whatever I tell you to do. That was the deal, remember?
I don't remember nothing about a dress.
Oh, no? Please, Billy, he said. Come back, I need you, Billy. Right after they hanged the Hunyak. You remember that, don't you? Yeah, you said,
"I'm sorry, I'm scared, I'll do anything you say."
Did you say that or didn't you?
Maybe I did.
So shut up about the dress. Now, we're clear about everything you're going to do in the stand, right?
Don't worry about me. I've been up all night rehearsing. I know every line.
All right, we'll get to my summation. Now I'll start off with justice in America, blah, blah, blah. Then I'll get to your repentance, blah, blah, blah. And then I'll say,
if sorrow could avail,
Fred Casely would be here now, for she would give her life gladly to bring the dead man back. You nod.
That's all?
That's all. And then I say, but we can't do that, gentlemen. You may take her life as the state demands, but it won't bring Casely back. That's always news to them. And then I go into my final statement, winding up. We can't give her happiness, but we can give her another chance. And that's all for you.
All for me?
That's it.
Like hell it is. It's me they want to see, not you.
It's my speech that brings them in, and it's my speech that'll save your neck.
If they can see it through all this crappy lace.
Look, I'm running this.
Screw you, you goddamn old crook.
Shut up, you dirty little...
His honor is waiting.
Thank you. Just a moment. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Hey, Roxy, don't be scared. It'll be all right. Look, I've been around a long time, and believe me, you've got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, nothing to worry about. Oh, Billy, I am worried.
It's all a circus, kid. A three-ring circus. These trials, the whole world, all show business. But, kid, you're working with a star. The biggest. Give them the old razzle dazzle. Razzle dazzle them. Give them an app with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give them the old hocus pocus. Feed and feather.
How can they hear the truth of all? certainly do.
Question by Sergeant Fogarty. What happened next? Answer by Roxy Hart. I shot him because he was walking out on me.
The louse.
Signed, Roxy Hart. Do you recognize this signature?
Yes, sir. That's the signature of the lady I used to be married to.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Hello, Amos.
Amos! That's right, Mr. Flynn. Amos!
Amos, you were at present obtaining a divorce from the defendant.
Yes, sir.
When did you file suit?
A few weeks ago.
Was there any reason for your filing for divorce at this particular time?
Well, I'll say. The newspaper said you was expecting a little stranger.
Well, that's hardly grounds for divorce, is it?
A little too much of a stranger.
Oh, by that you mean you down in the fraternity of the child?
Well, sure.
Did you question her after you read it? Did you even bother to ask her if you were the father?
No, sir, but you told me that
just I jumped to a conclusion. You call that playing square? Now let me ask you this, Hart. If you became convinced you were wrong, you'd be man enough to admit it, wouldn't you? You'd even be willing to take her back, wouldn't you? If Roxy Hart swore that you were the father of her child, which she does.
She does?
I do.
Step down, Daddy. Roxy Hart, the defense calls to the stand.
Roxy Hart to the stand. Blah, 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 blah. Good, good.
I do.
What is your name?
Roxy Hart.
Roxy, I have here a statement in which you admit having had illicit relations with the deceased, Fred Casely. Is this statement true or false?
I'm afraid that's true.
You're an honest girl, Roxy. When did you first meet Fred Casely?
When he sold Amos and me our furniture. Also, he was a regular patron at the nightclub where I was a member of the chorus.
And your personal relationship with Casely? Tell the jury, when did that begin?
When I permitted him to drive me home one night.
Hey, Chickie.
Hello, Mr. Casely.
My night for ducks, ain't it? Hey, I got my car around the corner. Why don't you let me give you a ride home? It's raining so hard and all.
Charleston! 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 Charleston!
Oh, he seemed like such a fine gentleman, and he dressed so elegantly.
Yeah, you were married, Mrs. Hart.
I know, and I don't think I would have gone with him if Mr. Hart and me hadn't quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled?
Yes, sir.
I suppose it was his fault.
Oh, no, sir, it was my fault. Seems I just couldn't stop pestering him.
Pester him? About what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to work in that cheap Southside nightclub. I don't like you working those long hours in the garage either. Oh, Amos, I want you home with me. I want to do your laundry. I want to darn your socks. I want to iron your shirts. I want a real home and a child.
So, you drifted into this illicit relationship with Fred Casely because you were unhappy at home.
Most unhappy.
I love you, honey. I love you. Yeah, you do respect the sacredness of the marriage vow.
Oh, yes, sir.
Then why did you continue this affair with Casely? Why didn't you stop?
I did want to. I tried to. But Mr. Casely, plead, and he'd say,
I can't live without you. I can't live without you. I can't live without you.
I love you, honey. I love you.
I was being torn apart.
Roxy Hart, the state has accused you of the murder of Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty. Not guilty. Oh, I killed him, yes. But I'm not a criminal.
Roxy Hart, can you describe the night of February 14th?
Yes, sir.
the jury, in your own way, the happenings of that night.
Well, it was after work about 2 a.m., and I dropped in at an all-night grocery store to pick up some baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos. Oh, my Amos just loved my cupcakes. And then I went right home, and I took my bath, and I was getting ready for bed, when suddenly the doorbell rang. Well, I thought it was my friend Gloria, so I slipped on my kimono and went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casey.
And what did he say, Roxy?
Hello, Roxy. I had to see you once more.
Why, Fred?
That note you wrote, telling me it was all over, telling me we had to quit, saying it could never end in happiness. Why did you write that note, Roxy?
Because I have reformed. Because I've seen the error of my ways, and
did he go away as you asked him to?
I object to counsel's leading the witness.
Shush, Jane.
I'll rephrase the question. And what did you say?
Oh, go away!
Hooray!
I tried to shut the door, but he forced his way in. I ran into the bedroom, but he followed me.
And then?
Look, just have one little drink with me and I'll go.
Why didn't you scream?
Because I was afraid of waking up the neighbors. Oh, please, no good will come of this. Besides, I love my husband.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
So, you told him you love your husband, and what did he say to that?
It doesn't matter. You're mine. You're mine. You're mine.
Oh, I can't go on. I can't.
No, no. No, Roxy. You must tell the jury everything. They have a right to know it.
Amos and me are going to have a baby.
And what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I see you have another man's child.
Diagram. Where were you at this time?
He was by the Victrola.
And where was Casely? Show the jury.
He was also by the Victrola.
Show the jury what happened next.
In his passion, he ripped off my kimono and threw me on the bed. Mr. Hart's gun was laying there between us. He reached for the gun. I knocked it from his hand. He whirled me aside.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun. But I got it first.
Hooray!
Then he came toward me with his funny look in his eyes.
What kind of look?
I don't know. Angry. Wild.
I mean to kill you.
Did you think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
Then it was his life or yours.
And not just mine. And I closed my eyes. Shot.
In defense of your life.
Mr. Billy Flynn, she weeps, but she fishes in her handbag and cannot find it.
handkerchief.
A handkerchief?
Finally, her attorney, Mr. Flynn, hands her one.
That's my gift.
Shh, I want to hear.
The poor child has had no relief. She looks around now, bewildered, seeming to want something. Oh, it's a glass of water. The bailiff has brought her one.
A glass of water? That's mine, too.
Mrs. Hart, her usual gracious self, thanks the bailiff, and he smiles at her. She looks simply radiant in her stylish blue lace dress and elegant silver shoes.
Silver shoes with buckles, rhinestone buckles.
With rhinestone buckles.
Velvet, don't break my radio.
But those were my shoes, and she stole them.
Well, you shouldn't have let them lay around.
First she steals my lawyer, my trial date, and now my shoes.
Well, what do you expect? She's a lowbrow.
The whole world's gone lowbrow.
Things ain't what they used to be.
They sure ain't, Mom. It's all gone. Whatever happened to fair dealing and pure ethics and nice manners? Why is it everyone now is a pain in the ass? Whatever happened to class?
Class. Whatever happened to please, may I? Yes, thank you. How charming. Now every son of a bitch is a snake in the grass. Whatever happened to class?
Class. Oh.
Beast, Red Casely.
forced his way into her home, forced liquor upon her, physically abused her, and threatened her life. At that moment, mother love and a deep concern for her neighbor stirred within her. She shot him. We don't deny that. But she has prayed to God for forgiveness for what she has done. You may take her life, but it won't bring Casely back. Look, look closely at that frail figure. My God, hasn't she been punished enough? We can't give her happiness, but we can give her another chance. You have heard my colleague call her temptress, call her adulteress, call her murderess. But despite what the prosecution says, things are not always what they appear to be. The defense
good, isn't it grand, isn't it great?
shorter and shorter. Let's make the music hotter. Let's all